Well, almost the entire state of Assam is currently facing one of the worst floods that the state has witnessed in the last 15 years. The death toll has now risen to 15. 43 lakh people have been affected. Nearly 30 of the total 33 districts in Assam are currently submerged. Over 4,000 villages across the state are reeling under the impact of the floods.
Districts like Dhemaji, Lakhimpur, Biswanath, Sontipur have all been severely affected. The river Brahmaputra is flowing above the danger mark, and if that level continues to rise, as is expected, the situation could be similar to the 2004 floods in Assam.
পানি যো বড়া হয় না কাল দেখা হয় কাল আল বহুত বড়া হয় আর এই শেষে বারণে সে তো ফেন্সি বাজার মাসখোয়া ভরলু পুরা ডুব জায়গা বহুত বড় হয় ও লাসিত যা মুক্তি হয় না ও সব সাত মিটার মার বাকি হয়
ইতনা পানি ইতনা সালো মে হমলোগ কবি পানি ইতনা দেখা নাই থা অবি ইতনা যো পানি কা স্থিতি হ্যায় ফেন্সি বাজার ডুবনে কা লপেট মে আ গিয়া পহলে পানি ইতনা হুয়া থা पर इतना डर का माहौल नहीं हुआ था
क्या कहना है मतलब देख ही पा रहा है आप और अगर ऐसे ही भरते जाएगा तो आज तो जो चांसेस है कि फैंसी बाजार डूब जाना और रास्ता में तो आने वाला है आप लोग देख रहे हैं यहाँ पे कितना आगे बढ़ रहा है और सुबह तक इतना पानी नहीं था विद इन 2-3 आवर्स जितना भर गया है अगर ऐसे ही भरते जाएगा तो चांसेस बहुत है डूबने का बहुत चांसेस है और रास्ता के तक तो आ ही जाएगा अगर ऐसे ही बारिश देते रहेगा तो पता ही चलेगा आप लोग तो देख ही रहे हैं यहाँ पे
Well, even as the NDRF and the SDRF continue their rescue operations in Baksa, the district administration sought army's help to evacuate stranded people in Baripurchar village that was inundated by the Beki River.
Well, the troops, along with the civil administration, evacuated 150 stranded villagers and shifted them to flood relief shelters. At present, 15 teams of the NDRF with 38 deep divers have been deployed. The NDRF has rescued over 2,500 people from the worst hit areas since the 11th of July. So that's the latest situation, and we're keeping track of what's happening in Kaziranga as well.
Well, the situation has worsened even at the World Heritage Site, the Kaziranga National Park. About 80% of the national park and 95 camps are under water.
Forest Department is on an alert on the National Highway 37 in order to avoid any poaching chances by hunters. A special rhino protection force has also been deployed in vulnerable locations of the national park.
Well, those are the latest details as far as Assam is concerned.
Meanwhile, Chief Minister Sarbananda Sonowal briefed Prime Minister Narendra Modi over the phone about the ground situation and the relief and rescue operations.
PM Modi has assured that the Chief Minister has all assistance from the centre.
Well, so the numbers there that are flashing on your screens are of those of the accounts where you can make your contribution to the Chief Minister's Relief Fund. And those pictures that you see are of areas which are hugely inundated. Borpeta, Golaghat, Morigaon, these are the areas which have been impacted. Several parts of Upper Assam, the districts in Upper Assam, have come under the deluge. All right, let's go across to Mr. Krishna Sharma, who comes from this region and who is, of course, somebody who can give us a real picture of what's happening on the ground. Mr. Krishna Sharma, good morning. We want to understand, you are a part of a group who have actually prepared a report on Assam floods. You have suggested solutions also, I believe. This is a yearly phenomena, perennial problem in that sense. But do you think that the government has failed in terms of preparedness in any way? Because this deluge seems to be one that has created a lot of devastation this year in particular.
Yes. Well, thank you for having me. I'm a Miss Krishna Sharma. We are part of a group called the Assam Floods Group, and it is an initiative under the aegis of the Delhi Alumni Association of Assam. And we have been working for the last, since 2016, actually, to prepare, to urge the government to prepare a comprehensive 20-year plan called the Brahmaputra Basin Water Management Plan, 2013. Was released by the governor of Assam on January 7, 2018 in Guwahati. And
right.
Our basic point is that the, you know, government after government has actually not paid attention to the Assam flood situation, which is perennial. It occurs every year. You know, biannually, you'll find there is, you know, a massive flood, and it comes in two spades. Once around this time, again around, say, August, September. And it is the same story each year. You can, like, you know, do some patchwork, which is what the government's attitude is. But there is no permanent solution to this, which I think is the most important thing to address. There was a report that was to come from the donor ministry and Niti Aayog, and the World Bank was working on it. In fact, we fed into that you know, process as well. But the report has been kind of sitting for the past 1 year, you know, without it coming out. So basically what we are saying is that one needs a long-term basin-wide plan. It cannot be a patchwork. You need the necessary, you know, resources to be outlaid. Like, you know, you have 20,000 crores for the Namami Gange program, and there is no such like allocation for the Brahmaputra River, which is a very long river.
Yes.
We also urge for a Brahmaputra Knowledge Center in the IIT Guwahati, and we wanted a flood forecasting and early warning system.
Right.
These are the things, and it's not as if, like, you know, we sat down and wrote it. We mm-hmm. actually got experts from IIT Roorkee, IIT Guwahati, people who have worked in, like, you know, earthquake and river systems, and as well as from Netherlands, from the Dell Terrace. And I'm very happy to share this, you know, report that we had submitted to the government. We sent, even now with the new water, you know, ministry, we have sent in even to the minister, Mr. Sekhawat. We hope that, like, you know, the addressing of this is done at two levels. One, immediate, like, you know, release of funds for the, you know, meeting the exigencies of this flood,
yes.
You know, now. And the second is, please look long-term for the next 20 years. How can we address the permanent problem? You know, in a situation like the Brahmaputra flood, there cannot be a very permanent solution because of, like, you know, topography, et cetera, et cetera. However, there can be certain things that can be done, which the experts say, which is, for example, you know, one of the recommendations of the earlier Water Resources Ministry was to build a large dam in Arunachal Pradesh.
Right.
We don't think that that is really a solution. One, because Arunachal government, I don't think, will allow for a very large dam to be built, because there'll be a whole lot of, like, you know, very sensitive area, tribal, biodiverse area that
yes.
will be submerged.
Yes. Right.
But the solution really lies in the small tributaries.
Right.
Actually, they're no longer small. They're really rivers on their own right.
Right.
There are about 40 tributaries that could be, like, you know, the upper catchment area could be treated, and
right.
you know, run of the water dams could be built. And there is already a plan, by the way, with the Brahmaputra board, which just needs to be updated. You know,
right.
Because those, I think, were made in the 1980s.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Those need to be updated. So, and the
right.
other solution that the government had is dredging of the river, which the dredging of the river will not be a solution.
Right. So those solutions, Krishna Sharma, does not work. In fact, there is an ASDMA, there is a flood control department, there are engineers. All these systems are there. But year after year, it's the same story. Thank you very much for giving us your perspective on where the governance has failed.
But for our viewers in these difficult times, you can do your own bit to help Assam, to donate to the Assam Chief Minister's Relief Fund, details of which will just come for you on your screens right now.
Over 10 dead and over 20 lakh affected. As the flood situation worsens in Assam, get the latest updates Assam Floods. Special coverage only on Mirror Now.